If a lawyer appearing before the Minnesota Supreme Court for the first time would have the chance to sit down and talk with me and I with him or her, I would give a few pieces of advice. The first piece of advice is answer the question. Now, in law school, you're taught in moot court, you got to answer the question. That's always the first piece of advice, but it's the first piece of advice for a reason, because so often lawyers don't answer the question. We presumably are prepared for the case. We've read the briefs, and then we have questions. We need to the answers to those questions to help us find the truth. And so many lawyers want to evade a difficult question. They pivot. That's the current word. We pivot away and get to the message that they want. That's the wrong strategy, because we wouldn't have asked the question if we didn't want the answer. And here's the problem. As soon as you evade a question, it's kind of like blood in the water, and then we're the sharks. We kind of start circling. So my advice to a lawyer appearing before us for the first time is, as you're preparing, come up with the five most difficult questions you don't want to answer. Write them down. And then write for each question the words yes, no, or Your Honor, I can't answer the question yes or no. And then once you answer yes or no, and then we'll let you explain. But if you don't answer the question yes or no, or tell us why you can't, then we're not going to be focusing on your answer. We're going to be focusing on wondering why you were afraid to answer the question. Another piece of advice I'd give to a lawyer appearing before us for the first time is go back to your speech class in high school or speech 101 in college. And remember, there's some things about oral argument as in everyday speaking. Use appropriate gestures, talk to us, don't talk to your notebook. I remember one case in particular where a lawyer took off his glasses and put them on top of his head, and then he stuck his pen up in the glasses. And we weren't listening to the argument. We were just wondering, boy, is the pen going to fall off? Are the glasses going to fall off? What the heck's going to happen here? So remember what your teacher taught you in speech class. And then finally, I think the hardest part of oral argument is rebuttal, where you have the chance to come back and refute what the previous lawyer has said. Rebuttal is very hard because there's a great temptation to try to answer everything, just go point by point. What we want you to do in rebuttal is pick a couple, three very important points, crystallize them, tell us what the rule of law is that your client is advocating and what remedy your client is seeking, and then tell us how the case should be decided. That's the way to win on rebuttal.